Good morning there. Paul here. I'm just sitting out the front of my house. And I want to ask you a question. What robes are you wearing? Now, reading today is coming from several different Bible readings, but there's an important message in there for us all. Out of Matthew 9 from verse 20, "And behold, a woman which was diseased with an issue of blood for 12 years came behind him and touched the hem of his garment. For she said within herself, if I may touch his garment, I shall be whole. But Jesus turned him about, and when he saw her, he said, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith has made thee whole. And the woman was made whole from that hour." And then in Mark 6, verse 56, we read, "And wherever he went, villages and towns and countrysides, they laid the sick in the marketplace and begged him to let them just touch the fringe of his cloak. And all who touched him were healed." Then when we go back and to Exodus in the Old Testament, Exodus 28, verse 33, we learn how they made the robes of the priests. It says this, "Make pomegranates of blue, purple, and scarlet yarn around the hem of the robe with gold bells between them. The gold bells and the pomegranates are to alternate around the hem of the robe. Aaron must wear it when he ministers. The bells represent the gifts and the pomegranates represent the fruit of the Spirit." And in Galatians 5 we read about them, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. And the 12 gifts of the Holy Spirit are the word of wisdom, word of knowledge, faith, gifts of healing, miracles, prophecy, distinguishing between the spirits, and tongues." In 1 Corinthians 13 it says, "If I speak in tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all the mysteries of knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing." And in 1 Peter 2, verse 9, it says, "You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood." We're all priests. A nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. In Isaiah 61, verse 10, it says, "I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall be joyful in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness." So you can see where this is all going. We need to pursue love earnestly and desire the spiritual gifts, especially that we may prophesy. Without love and without God, we can do nothing, for God is love. As we travel through life as his ambassadors, let us remember these things. We are the royal priests, blessed to carry his love and his spirit to the troubled world. We're created in him to do good works which he has prepared in advance for us to do. So that's the challenge. What sort of robes are we wearing? Do we have the bells and the pomegranates on the edge of our garment, as the priest did in the Old Testament? The bells representing the gifts and the pomegranate representing the fruit. And if we don't have love, which is the first fruit, then we're not going to be endowed with the gifts of healing or prophecy or whatever. We really need to pursue love, pursue that fruit of love in everything that we do, and love the Lord your God with all your heart. Love your neighbor as yourself. It's so important that we pursue love and have it on our garments, on our robes of righteousness. Have the fruit of love before we can do anything for Jesus. Have a great day. God bless you. Get into his word and let his word get into you. We'll see you later. Bye.